Hi, I'm Lisa Hayes, owner of Auntie Soulful Kitchen. That is located at 1430 Olive, first floor. This is where you get your home cooked meal, like Big Mama used to cook. And marketing, which I've already know that part, the street hustle of it. So I just kind of turned my street hustle into a legal business. Now, instead of me being out there and being illegal, now I am legal. I was in the streets, and being street smart, I just reversed it into a positive meaning. That's one reason I spelt ATs in a negative way, to turn a negative word into a positive meaning. And you can do that, anybody can do that in your life. When you get sick and tired of being sick and tired, trust me, it's at that point when you'll turn it around and make things positive. So what I did was I spelled it A-I-N-T-E-E, apostrophe L, so it's a negative word, and I'm feeding your soul, so that'll be S-O-U-L-F-U-L, and it's a kitchen, because that's what I am, I'm a kitchen. That'll make it feel like home-cooked feeling of the food. It ain't nothing like Big Mama cooking. You know, Big Mama, I'm talking about Big Mama, where we all used to sit at the table, when you got hand-me-downs and all that stuff, when we knew how to really be good with the life. These days they got too much technology going on, so they'll Google it and find out how to do things. They don't do it by hand no more. We all have to definitely not waste time, because time is not promised. It's promised for us to do better with the time. And in this place, I know God has me here because it's people that's more unfortunate than I am, and I have a big heart and understand what all is going on. And he's making me change as I see the people that's around here homeless, you know, in situations and different situations, unfortunately. But I see that God is still working in their lives as well, so I try to encourage them to keep on moving. Keep on going through that. Because you won't know what happened on the other side until you get on the other side.
Hey. How you doing?
Oh my goodness. How you feeling, sister? I'm sorry.
No, you're fine.
All right. How can I help you, sister?
Can I get two bacon cheese? Yep.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll be back to pick it up.
All right, 5 minutes, sister. Thank you.
Okay, all right, thanks.
You're welcome. Bye. Once I turned my life around, yes. Auntie, how can I help you? Yes, ma'am, I got chicken wings. I got whole wings, not party wings. Yes, ma'am. The whole wings, I believe that's more meat, first of all. We always looking for how much more. Okay, and the party wings, to me, I can't get a decent size, and we like good portions. If we gonna spend our money and go somewhere, first of all, it's the travel to get there and the encouragement to go there and good food. You gonna go. So my thing is to keep it consistent, and that's what I do. The whole wing thing is just the image. The way you present yourself. It's a presentation. That's all it is. If you set forth a good presentation, there's good things to come after that. Oh no, you got to have your real wings when you mess around. The whole catfish, the whole jack. Ain't no partial. When grandmama used to do it, we used to do it. I've been this way all my life, basically, and I chose to do this at an early age. first girlfriend being 11 years old, I think I made a good decision. And I learned how to see love between the lines in a lot of situations and relationships that I had. And that wasn't with a man, that was basically with women. And I learned to be comfortable with that, and I, with God and my spirit and my mother, before she passed, was very comfortable with my lifestyle. My family is very supportive. I have also gay people in my family. I have 3 stepchildren, 2 beautiful daughters and a son. I knew I couldn't have kids, reason being of my lifestyle. So God blessed me with some through someone, which is my ex. But I was blessed with children out of the situation. This thing about being a father, it doesn't really matter about the woman at all. It's about being there for them children.
I can make a miracle happen when I got inspection. She said, you sure you're going to be able to hold it on with this weak grill? So I was able to just keep everything at a minimum. I saved myself thousands. Well, God saved me thousands of dollars to where I just made it economically to be here. It's a small household stuff. Still make money.
This thing is just
okay.
But it's okay.
Yeah, technically.
Okay. Thank you, sister.
Okay.
You have a blessed day.
All right, you too. Thank you.
Thank you more.
It's excellent. I come here about 2 or 3 times a week here. When I'm in the building. Yeah. But I love it.
Yeah.
Okay, see ya. Alright, no problem.
Alright. God bless you.
I saw everybody out there. Yeah, the best friend I had in a long time.
You know what? It's lighter if you get the pressure off of you and on to somebody else. That makes them feel better at that time to say, oh well, shit, I just dropped it off on you now. Your fault, you know. And really, the main thing is, what God wants you to do is take your own responsibility where you're wrong at and when you're right. You got to take responsibility of who you are and what you stand for. And if you don't, you won't be. You'll just keep going doing the same thing. I know people still doing the same thing, Bobby. Years over the years.
Yeah, actually I did time in Vandalia. I got caught with marijuana, 13 pounds. I mean, I did do rehab in penitentiary, which was good for me. It actually gave me some strength. I actually needed that at the time to do the correct things. It's okay to get things correct. See, when you got your life in your hands and you want to do self-willed things, there's consequences behind that. And we have to realize that. Are you willing to do what you do and do the consequences? It's 2 different things. So if you want to do the right thing, you know right is going to follow you. So that's basically it. You had to cut all that negative out. And that's what I did. I kind of narrowed it down to what I would have never thought it was cooking. And you your worst enemy sometime. And I was. I can only speak for myself. I was my worst enemy, but I did find out what was best for me in the end was what God had for me. And my purpose was what he wanted for me, not really what I wanted in these streets. Focus on yourself. You can't worry about others until you can. You're powerless over others until you get yourself together. And constant is change. You have to keep changing in order for you to get it right. Don't be afraid of that. If you get very comfortable and stuck in certain situations, don't do that. You have to be willing to have changes and willing to change and let some things go in order for you to be positive in life. Because it's the best food in town, I'm trying to tell you. I put my love and I pray over all things. Thank you for your time. Thank you for listening, for number one. And you have a blessed day. This is Auntie Soul Food Kitchens, 1430 Olive, downtown on the first floor. God bless.